Hi, this is Steve Michelotti from the Azure Government Engineering Team. I'm joined today by Sachin, my colleague, also from the Azure Government Engineering Team, and we're going to talk about monitoring on Azure Government. Welcome, Sachin.
Thank you, Steve.
All right, so I guess the most logical thing for us to start out with is, what is Monitor on Azure Government and what can you do with it?
Azure Monitor is a very important platform service that enables a common pipeline for retrieving and accessing metrics, diagnostic logs, and other type of monitoring-related data from all sort of Azure resources in a common place. The data then can be visualized on the portal, can be also accessed via CLIs, PowerShell, and REST APIs, and used to further create action items on top of that data, like alerting and notifying people.
Okay, so sometimes people have these concerns that if I deploy to the cloud, I might not have visibility as to what's going on in my resources. This cloud is a scary thing. I don't know what's up there. And with Azure Monitor, we can get visibility into those things, is what I hear you saying.
Absolutely. And it's one common thing. So you have to subscribe to one thing, okay. And then as new resources pop up and they onboard to monitor, you do not have to change your code to access the data. It's already there.
Okay. All right. So I heard you talk about different sources. What are some of the sources we have here?
So most important sources are the compute sources. That's where your websites are running. That's where VMs are running and doing a lot of activities, running the production systems and things like that. And those are the very important ones to monitor first. So some of the sources for monitoring data are application and metrics from your applications, as well as the VMs, if you are using VMs, guest OS logs, activities log. Activities logs are Azure infrastructure monitors, monitor activities against the resource. So if you delete or create a resource or perform any activity against it, these are also part of the whole pipeline there.
So not just runtime information from logs, but even administrative activities like creating and deleting resources.
Absolutely. Okay. So someday you come in and see a new resource popped up, you can go back to the monitor and see like who created it, when it was created, things like that.
Great, okay. Well, you definitely got me interested here, but I think I need you to prove this to me with a demo.
Absolutely. And before we get there, I also wanted to kind of go back to our slide here, is there are one arrow that points to multiple ways you can access the data, so you can read out to other services like notification service and things like that. You can dump the data, archive in a storage account, use the REST APIs for real time, visualize all sort of things. So
okay, great.
Let's go to the demo. Okay, so there we are on the Microsoft Azure Government portal. I have pre-created some resources that we're going to monitor.
Okay, great.
So very first thing we do is go to the monitoring blade, and you'll see a couple of things there. So let's start looking at them. The very first thing by default that shows up is activities log. So basically, it's going to list down a few things that I have done since this morning. I can do some filtering on top of it, apply it, show me the data for last 6 weeks, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, things like that. And also, I can filter the data based off of resource groups, resources, things like that.
So activity logs are things that happen with Azure resources, like creating resources, deleting resources, or listing keys, that sort of thing.
Absolutely.
Gotcha.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Next big thing is the metrics. So metrics include performance and health-related data from compute services and non-compute services. Like if you're running a web service, you want to be very careful about the CPU utilization on it.
Yeah.
Like if the CPU utilization goes up, I want to know when it reaches certain threshold. So those are the metrics we're going to look at here. So I'm going to quickly select the resource group that I have pre-created. Going to my resource, that's the storage account. And we're going to quickly look at a couple of most important ones that I at least monitor myself every day, is end-to-end latencies and server latency for my storage account.
So already as I'm seeing you do this, I'm seeing these phrases like activity log and metrics and alerts, and I heard you talk about these terms back on the slides, and now I'm seeing these concrete examples now in the portal.
Absolutely. So there is some activities around my metrics of my storage account, and I can definitely change the time range, change the type of the chart, and things like that. And the cool thing here up is I can pin this to my dashboard. So I'm going to pin it, and I can go back to the dashboard quickly and come and look at it every morning. I do not have to go back to the monitoring blade and repopulate the chart. It's right there. I can visualize it anytime I would come to the portal.
Okay, now I see that this is your default dashboard that you got when you logged into the portal, and it kind of just got added to what you have existing on this dashboard.
Yes. So My dashboard did not have much stuff, so I kind of added the chart to an existing one. But if you have a customized workload, like if you running a website as part of your team, then you might want to create your own dashboard, and I can quickly go ahead and add a new dashboard here. And then you can add related charts on this dashboard for various monitoring and charting activities.
Okay, so I can have my own dashboard where maybe I have a dashboard for a certain application or solution, and another dashboard for a different application, and another dashboard for network health or whatever my imagination is the limit.
Absolutely. The simplest scenario is you have a team managing the back-end systems, and you have a team managing front-end systems, and you can have separate dashboard with related services on it.
Okay. So I can pin these to any dashboard I want.
Absolutely.
Okay.
The next thing we will quickly touch base with is alerts. So we talked about activities logs, we talked about metrics. What about if I want to get notified when something changes, like some new resource gets created, or my metrics start sending me, say, CPU is reaching the threshold, or I'm getting too much latency when requesting, my front end is requesting data from my back end, things of that nature. We can use alerts to set notifications on this, and I'm going to try to get one here. So we looked at the metrics for our storage account, and this is where I can simply go and say add metrics alert, give it a name, a couple of other properties. I can specify how I would like to get alerted using emails, or if you have a webhook configured, this all can be configured.
So I can email, I can page someone and wake someone up in the middle of the night if I want. Okay.
Absolutely. It can integrate with your other monitoring and or service-oriented operation systems.
Okay.
I'm going to cancel it and talk about a couple of other things. Autoscale. Autoscale is another way to proactively make your services are scaling up based on the demand. So we talked about the metrics and how the metrics indicate the CPU utilization, the queue lengths, the disk IOs, and things like that. I can use that information at a runtime to automatically scale my application. So if I'm running a VM scale set, or if I'm running a virtual web service or web app, I can use those parameters to simply say like double down the number of nodes or scale up my VMs, things like that.
So if I start getting a huge spike in traffic and I'm not in front of my computer to move the slider to scale my instances, I can rest peacefully knowing I've already got this proactively set up. It'll scale it up for me.
Absolutely.
Gotcha.
And again, you can put the notification so it will tell you that this is what happened.
I'll get an email letting me know. Okay, yeah. Gotcha.
Action groups are quick things to combine the set of items and the people that you want to get notified when certain things happen. So you can create action groups and specify like SMS, phone numbers for SMS, email IDs, and things like that. We probably go ahead and create one from here.
But so this is if I'm notifying a whole group of people, not just one person.
Absolutely.
Okay.
So if you have a team you want to notify, or if you have like email, we talked about if you have SMSs that needs to be sent, all that stuff. The last thing on this particular blade that we want to discuss about is diagnostic settings. And this is how you control for specific resources what happens to the data. We talked about the data coming from various Azure resources. We have a common place to have that data, what we want to do about it. We can visualize few things in real time. We can also set alerts, notifications, things like that. But what about my historical data? If I have logs for 3 weeks, 6 weeks, what I'm going to do? How effectively I can query that? And this is where we're going to go to diagnostic settings. And I have pre-created a setting, so we're going to quickly review that.
So let me make sure I understand where we're going here. You're saying I might be monitoring different sources, web server logs, event logs, but then I can then put those somewhere else?
Yes.
Historically archive them?
Right. So in the very beginning, we talked about what can be done with this monitoring data. You can read out to a different service. You can take action like alerts, notifications. You can also do auto-scaling. But same time, you can archive this information for future uses, or if you wanted to go in the past and diagnose something or audit something. So for that, you can choose a storage account and simply archive your data in a storage account.
Okay.
And it allows you to set a retention policies on both metrics as well as on diagnostic data. And diagnostic data includes your application logs, IaaS logs, crash dumps, things of that nature. And metrics are performance and health metrics.
So we can archive all of this stuff.
We can archive all of that.
Gotcha.
The second option, this allows you to pipe this data to Event Hub. So if you have integration points where you want to have other services retrieve that data, Event Hub. And the cool part of this is that I can go back and retrieve and review that data anytime I want. So I have already set up this thing, so I'm going to quickly take a peek at the storage account and see how this data actually looks like there.
Okay.
So for both diagnostic logs as well as metrics, we have separate containers created. And if you can drill into the containers, there is going to be a long path for each of the resources from where the monitoring data is coming from. So you can easily identify. And there's going to be multiple files indexed by days, hours, and things like that for effective retrieval. And they're going to be there for the retention period that you set.
So you just flipped over here to Azure Storage Explorer, which allows us to visually see our storage account and what's contained in there.
Absolutely.
Okay.
But again, as you can see, if I'm running a production service that has a lot of services running, a lot of activities are happening, it's nearly impossible for anyone to go into the Storage Explorer and try to make sense of the data. So how we solve that problem? And we're going to quickly discuss another solution on Azure Government, and that is Log Analytics. Another cool solution on Microsoft Azure Government. Log Analytics is slightly different than Monitor. It does collect a lot of information, but it has a very good tooling for quickly analyzing and searching against that data. And also, Log Analytics enables you to collect data from your on-prem resources as well. So it is complementing monitors as well as serving other purposes. But in this particular conversation, we're going to focus on the integration with Monitor. As you can see on the slide, there are multiple sources that data can come through. And then again, there are several different ways you can use that data to perform actions, visualize, and send it to other services, export, things like that.
So is Log Analytics querying that storage account you were just showing us in Storage Explorer, or is it querying everything?
So storage account is just going to archive this data. When we configure the diagnostic settings to also send the data to Log Analytics, there is a separate process in real time moving that data over to a different storage that is optimized for real time querying.
So a Log Analytics has its own repository of that data.
Absolutely, with a very fast search engine on top of
it.
So this data, we will now go to our Log Analytics workspace and try to kind of query our data. Going back to, and this is the setting I was talking about, so send to Log Analytics. And from here, you can create a new Log Analytics workspace or use an existing one to send this data to. I have already done that, so I'm going to skip this piece, and we will quickly go back to Log Analytics workspace.
Okay. So we're still in the portal, but we're now drilling into your Log Analytics workspace.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Here we are on the Log Analytics blade. Now, you can see a lot of stuff going on in here, but we probably don't have time to dive into all of these. So we're going to focus on just querying the data that's coming from the monitoring that we configured earlier. So I'm going to go ahead and click on Log Search. And this place is going to allow us to run real-time queries against our data. It has a very efficient query language to be used for analyzing the data and also creating charts and other type of visualizations. But there is a cooler thing than this. I would go to advanced analytics because I like to be close to the data. So we're going to click that, but I already have some sample queries pre-created, so we're going to just quickly touch base.
So this is a separate portal from the Azure Government portal. This is the Log Analytics portal, but we can link to it directly from the Azure Government portal.
Absolutely. So this is just a separate workspace for you to very closely, intimately kind of engage with the data, but this is part of the system, so it's not going to prompt you for a re-authentication or any of that.
Okay.
Now, we are going to quickly review the type of data this has, and there are multiple sources as we discussed can send the data. We're not going to review all of that. So I'm going to quickly go back to our topic is Azure Diagnostic and Activities Log and Monitors. So this query right here is simply giving me aggregate count on operations performed against the resource.
And you just ran that query.
That's
how quickly it responded.
It is very fast. And this, the way this table kind of drawing the data doesn't look very neat, so we're going to go and have some charting here. And I'm just going to go and do a pie chart. And basically what it shows is the number of operations performed against a resource that I had created and the distribution. So get keys, obviously I'm using key vault here. So get keys, create, and operations like that. The second example is, since we were looking at the metrics data from storage and the latencies that we looked in Azure Portal, now the same data I'm using from log analytics to draw a chart that indicates how the latencies are varying over a period of time.
Okay.
Now, I'm just querying this for last 24 hours, but if there is a data for several weeks, several months, this is still going to be very fast retrieval. Portal doesn't have that much long time span. It's more for quickly reviewing past day, 24 hours, an hour, things like that. But for longer than that, you might want to come to log analytics.
Okay, so for log analytics, you can really drill down at a granular level to exactly the data that you're interested in, beyond just the high-level things that Portal gives you.
Absolutely.
Okay.
And again, this place will have data from all other sources, from your VMs, from your on-prem machines, network, things like that. So you can slice and dice data several ways and diagnose and things more.
And this is just the log query functionality of log analytics, not even all that other stuff you mentioned. So right. Very powerful tool. Your next video will bring you on to do a deep dive into log analytics. Okay. All right. So this has been a hugely informative demo. I guess the last question I have is, how would someone get started with monitoring in Azure Government? It looked pretty easy, everything you were doing. How would one get started?
Okay, so here are some resources for anyone to refer, read about how the monitors log analytics work and how to get started quickly.
Okay, great. All right, well, this has been an extremely informative session. Thanks for coming on and sharing your knowledge about monitoring in Azure Government. This has been Steve McElotti, along with my colleague Sachin on the Azure Government Engineering team, talking about all the things you can do with monitoring in Azure Government. Thanks for watching.